Hi everyone, I'm Siddharth Paswal. I will be presenting a paper for EVA generating longitudinal electronic health records using variational autoencoders. EHR systems are widely used to collect and maintain patient health records. Synthetic EHR data refers to synthetically generated EHR data which mimics the real-world data distribution. The question is, why do we need EHR data? First, electronic health records data sharing is very challenging as it contains intellectual property and different sensitive data elements. Privacy preservation of EHR data is also very challenging. The potential benefits of EHR data generation is that healthcare institutions can easily release and share data. It can also improve model performance with data augmentation. Software and data analytics pipeline development also becomes easier with synthetic EHR data. For that, we present EVA, which is a variational autoencoder, which is a combination of latent variable model and amortized variational inference. The input for this model is a collection of n patients where each patient is represented as a variable length collection of visit vectors, where the visit vector is encoded as presence or absence of ICD codes. We use a latent variable Z, which is typically endowed with standard Gaussian priors. Given all the data samples, we learn the model using maximizing the marginal likelihood of the data. We use a bidirectional LSTM as our encoder, and we use a combination of deconvolution layer and a mask convolution layer as our decoder. We also present EVA-C, which is a hierarchically factorized conditional EVA, which can generate conditional data. It allows for generation of case and control cohort, which is very useful for predictive modeling. EVA-C is parameterized using global variables H and theta, which is shared across all patients. And we also use patient-specific related variables C, W, B, and epsilon to generate the data. We perform extensive experiments on different baselines on a large data set containing over 250,000 patients. First, we show that EVA is able to outperform the baselines by capturing the similar data distribution which is present in the real EHR data. We also show that the predictive performance of EVA is improved when we combine the synthetic data with the real data to train a predictive model. And similarly, EVA-C also helps with the improved model performance when it can generate disease-specific data sets. Finally, we conclude with presenting a model which is used for generating synthetic temporal EHR data. It can also generate disease-specific EHR data, and overall, the model performance of predictive models is improved by adding the synthetic data generated by EHR data. Thank you.